Good morning, everybody. My name is Surya, and I'm from Olympus. Today, one of the things which I wanted to discuss was a new line of HTHA probes, which will give you much more clarity and much more understanding in evaluating or inspecting of HTHA proven areas. So let's start. So anytime you guys have any questions, I'll have a Q&A session in the end and we'll have a discussion on that. So basically HTHA usually happens when at higher temperature, hydrogen atoms fuse into the material of the pipeline and cause a weakening or causing a softening effect on the pipes. So because of this, the pipelines, as you can see in the images attached here, they will weaken the strength of the pipe and they will cause a rupture. So due to this, there have been now few cases in US where HTHA has been taken as a much more stringent or much more difficult area where we have to put much more focus on. For that, we have detected, we have brought forth HTHA series of probes, which can be used for detecting HTHA at a much earlier stage, thereby helping us prevent any further disasters. So let's talk about the technology. So to detect a HTHA, what do you require? You require greater detection capability. To get a greater detection capability, you need either to use a DLA or smaller elements and higher frequency. By using the combination of these three techniques, you will be able to get a higher detection rate. So how does DLA help? In DLA, you can have a higher gain can be used because DLA does not, DLA means dual linear. So in that it does not affect or it does not suffer from the same shortcomings of linear phased array. In DLA, we can use a higher gain. So when we are using a higher gain, our signal to noise ratio will be automatically improved. Then smaller elements. When we are using smaller elements, our ability to focus, the physical ability to focus within the component is also increased. Then higher frequency. As we all know, if you are using a higher frequency of probe, that is going to give a higher resolution or increased resolution, which will improve in your detectability. So when we combine all these three techniques into one and use it for a detection of HTHA, we will get a much better results. So efficient probes, as I already told, smaller elements with greater coverage in the both weld and the HSD zone will improve your speed of inspection and make you more efficient in the whole process. And if you are talking about whole pipeline inspection, then instead of a smaller probe, like if you use a RIX 1 probe, it will give you a larger coverage and also it is adaptable between a various range of thicknesses and diameter of pipeline. So you will have a better chance of finding defects and also inspecting at a much faster rate. Comprehensive and easy to use. With these techniques, like as I explained before, these probes can be directly configured with the new OmniScan X3. And with combined with these, you will be able to do it much more easily. And it's almost a plug and play operation. So let's see the values each probe is providing. So these three probes, we have the A32, REX1 and the DLA, A20. So these three probes are combining multiple technologies. You will be able to use both PAUT and TFM with these probes. And they have very high resolution. Like you have all of these are 10 MHz, which is going to give you much more resolution on the defects or on the HTHA joints which you are inspecting, and you can use them for 0 degree or for the whole pipeline, or you can use the A28 dual linear for HTHA weld inspection and the HSE area. Also, one of the things which we would like to add is we have a TOFT series of probes for HTHA in which you can, because TOFT is a faster, it is almost the fastest technique compared to everything. TOFT is going to give you a faster screening tool and it is very much sensitive to HTHA for smaller voids. And there is a wide range of probes and TOFT wedges which are available. So let's talk about the dual array 828 pitch. In this one, using this one, it uses a pitch catch technique. Because it's a dual array, it is a pitch catch. In pitch catch, we have a very high high gain, which we can allow into the material. As you can see here, even with the higher gain, you are getting a very good signal response compared to the noise of the available in the parent material. So as you can see here, the noise level is kept minimum, whereas we are able to see the indications which are present inside the material much more clearly. And with the higher steering capacity in this probe, you will be able to get a good coverage in both in the weld region and in the HAC. So you're not only inspecting one area, but you are inspecting a whole component together. Then dual array RIX-1 probe. This is a 0-degree wedge with an integrated wedge. So this probe is used for scanning larger areas, whereas the 828 is going to be used primarily for weld and the HAC region. But if you want to cover a larger area, then you have to go for RIX-1. By using these probes at 30 mm coverage, you can cover a large area and it enables very fast scanning in the 0 degrees. So combined with the passive and electronic focusing in this one, the range of thickness in which you can use this is very wide, and you'll be able to get very good results with it. And then the last one, 831 and 832. You might already know these probes as our standard weld series probes, but these probes have been introduced specifically again for HTHA with a higher frequency. So you will be able to get a much more improved sensitivity on the very small or fine HTHA voids. Product features. So product feature of the RIX-1 probe. As I already mentioned, this probe is a 64 element probe with 10 MHz. One of the major advantages of this probe is it is adjustable. So if you want to scan a very small pipe, that is say 4 inches in OD, all you have to do is you have to open this clip, place the probe on the pipe, and then clip it again. And this probe will be set for that particular dia. And as you move up the dia or you are changing the dia, all you have to do is you have to change the clip, and you will be able to fix this probe on any diameters from 4 inches to flat. This single probe will be able to do it. And this probe can be attached with a mini wheel to prove as used as an encoded scanning. So you can have a recording of your CSC scan data. And this wedge is an integrated wedge. So it is not a removable wedge. So since it is integrated, it allows for greater acoustic signal, which is very critical for HTHA inspection. Also, the cable is located on the back so that when you're using any scanner, the cable is not going to be a hindrance to you, and it'll be easier to use. And since we are going to be scanning a large surface areas, the probe wear should be kept minimum. For that, we have added carbide strips, which you can see here. And these carbide strips will be the first one to worn out. So once these carbide strips are worn out, you would have scanned kilometers of data by the time. So once those are worn, all you have to do is change these carbide pins, and they will again be good as new. So you're not damaging the probe, you are damaging only the carbide pins which are there for the job. Next one, 828. This, again, as I explained earlier, is a dual 32 element probe. So you have 1 to 32 elements on this side and 33 to 64 element on that side. So by using these probe, you will be able to scan on both the weld joint and as well as the HAC region, and you will be able to get good results out of it. So any HTHA which is present, you will be able to find out. And these probe has a patented pivot system, which means because we are changing thicknesses or we are changing depending upon the radius of the job which you are doing, the wedge will be changing. Because of the patented pivot system, these wedges will be able to automatically adjust according to the wedge which you're putting, and this will give you a good roof angle, which is close to the required value. And the major advantage which I have to mention for this particular series of probe is, this can be used from thicknesses of 4 mm to 95 mm. So you will know the versatility of this particular probe. And it covers the curvature from 4 inches OD to flat. So by using this probe, single probe, you will be able to cover this much range much easily than compared to anything else. So this is just a chart where we compare all these. We have, like as I explained, we have the A28, which is for the weld and HAZ area. Then you have the REX probes for both, for the majorly used for corrosion mapping, or you will be able to scan larger areas of pipes with it. And you have the A31 and A32 probes. And I have to mention all these probes for HTHA series are high frequency and 10 megahertz. And based upon the thickness in which you are inspecting, you will be changing the wedges as required. And I told you A28 probe can be used anywhere from 4 mm to 95 mm. So if you are using from 4 mm to 45, you have to use a specific wedge. And if you're using from 45 to 95, you have to use a different. So one thing which would change in this is how the probe wedge is allowing the focus. That is the only thing which is going to be changed. So you don't need to get a separate probe for inspecting this. All you have to do is you have to get a separate wedge for the depending upon the thickness in which you require it. So finally, a comparison on how each technology like phased array and TFM look at HTHA joints. So you are having as inspection using a REX1 probe and a pulse echo. So you will be able to see both of them here. And if you're using TFM on by using these HTHA, you will get a much better signal with much less noise signal, much better signal to noise ratio. And you will be able to get a signal like this. So in conclusion, HTHA probes help you get a much better signal on the HTHA joints in which we are inspecting, especially the Olympus range, which gives you a good 10 megahertz frequency that is much suited for the resolution of these joints. So I think that is it from my side. If you guys have any questions, I'll answer. Please, I'll be available in the Olympus exhibition stall, and you can come to video channel and you will be able to have a discussion with us. Thank you, everyone.